Hopefully having a good week so far. Well, let me ask Jay, what's something exciting happening for you this week?
Hi everyone. This week is usual for me, but sometime like 10 minutes before, it was a really exciting thing which happened with me. The one of my lab mate brought some sweet, Indian sweet, and it was like in a microwave oven, and he asked me to have it. It was so hot, like I'm feeling that burning sensation. And I'm taking cold water to make it like neutralize it. So it was really hot. So, but it was good to taste.
It's good. Okay, it's like exciting
Thank you.
taste then. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's good. What about Kasumi? What is exciting for you this week?
Hi. Today my husband's birthday. So evening. I'm going to baking cake and I cook the dinner. It will be exciting today.
No, it sounds good, Kasumi.
Thank
Are you a very good cook, Kasumi?
you.
Okay. Well, thank you. Elmer, I saw your little son driving your car, so that's exciting. Yeah, that's an exciting car ride with a little boy driving. Speaking of driving, Liazette, what is something exciting going on with you this week?
Hello. Actually, I'm trying to get exciting from tiny things, but we never notice it, but I'm trying it. Don't correct me, please. My son up behind me. So I get exciting from tiny things, but it's very important things. I think if I woke up very healthy this morning and I can see, I can breathe, and I can walk, it's exciting for me. And my kids are healthy this morning and they are went to the school. That's exciting to me too. So that's every minute for me is exciting. Every day for me is exciting because everybody, I didn't hear the bad news. That's exciting for me. So every day is every hour is exciting for me. Thank you so much.
Realize that you have a very exciting life all the time, so.
Yeah, I love my life.
Jay, did you have a question?
Yeah, she said very positive thing. Like nothing bad news is like really exciting. And I truly agree with that. It's a really a matter like we don't hear anything bad means everything is going very well. It's good.
Yeah, I think that's the
Thanks.
best way to approach life. So.
Yes, thank you.
Well, I see we have a new student today. Can I call you Tan?
You can call me that.
Dad,
Yeah.
okay.
Yes.
Dad, my friend, what is something exciting going on with you this week?
This week, only from Monday until now. From Monday until
Yeah,
now.
Monday till now.
Yeah. So I think yesterday is exciting to me because I come back the Toastmaster class and the exciting is I meet my old friend is Stefania. Yeah, she surprised me because I don't know her in this class. And we met each other 2 weeks, yeah, last 2 weeks well, we meet at the UAB. So she's the most exciting last night.
Yeah, I'm glad you came last night. I was really happy to see you again.
Yeah. Actually, I don't know your schedule, so I'm surf the Facebook and I see Toastmaster Facebook and I see the time and the rest. So I'm curious and searching. Maybe I can come there or not because in downtown so difficult to ride and to parking. I remember you said after 5 p.m. we can parking outside. So yesterday, no one call me. Yeah, I don't see any police call me. So I'm happy. Maybe next time I will try the class more often.
Yeah, that's good. Some people don't know that. And, you know, parking in the metered spots on the street, that's free in Birmingham after 5. So you can park anywhere on the street.
Yeah.
Just try not to park in the handicap spots.
Yeah.
But other than that, you're fine.
Even the person that live very long time here, they don't know about that.
Yeah. Not a lot of people do, because most big cities, that's not true. But Birmingham is not a big city. So they, yeah. They stop, the ticket people stop working after 5. Well, that's good. I'm glad you're here with us. I hope you can continue to come. Okay. But of course, we have to hear from Stefania. What is something exciting that happened to you this week?
Hi. This week, maybe I watching the Avatar series on Netflix, and it's very good and it's amazing, and all the scenes and the I don't know how to say the actors are so good. This is the most amazing in this week.
Issa, is it the Avatar, The Last Airbender?
Yes.
That one? Okay. Yeah, I've heard of that. Do you watch that in English or Spanish, Stefania?
I watch it in English.
In English? Good. Very good.
Yes. But
one of the best ways to learn.
Subtitles in Spanish. Yes.
That's okay. That's okay. Yes. You need to hear English, though.
Yes. It's good.
I'm glad you like that. Let me ask Wes one more person. Hey, Zeus, what is something exciting that happened to you this week?
Good afternoon. This week, I'm very busy for me, but I'm working in finishing my thesis work, the document. I written my thesis work. I'm very very busy in general. The week is very busy, but I'm. All time, I grade my document. I review for article for my thesis.
Well, you're probably happy to be close to done with that. If you're close to done with your thesis, that's very exciting. I know you like to stay busy. Well, let's go ahead and start the lesson for today. Let me share my screen with you here. And the first, so it looks like our friends at Lingo X, they decided to give us a lesson chapter on animals, which is fine because I am going to March the 22nd, which is a Friday, I'm going to go to the Birmingham Zoo, and I want to invite all of you to come and join me. We can walk around the zoo, we can look at the animals, we can talk to each other, we can practice conversation, and it will be a good time for us all to just kind of hang out with each other and practice conversation in a comfortable place. So I'll keep posting reminders about that. But just remember, it is on a Friday. So Friday, March the 22nd. So this is a quick little vocabulary lesson on animals that you would see at the zoo. And so I'm going to ask students to read the whole row here. So we have 4 rows. And let me ask Debbie, can you read this first row for me?
Okay. Okay, no problem. Insects, fish, bird, bear.
Yeah, so that's pretty easy. Very good, David. Well, Giovanna, can you do the second one for me?
I don't know this. Rhino?
Oh, yeah, interesting. Rhino. Rhino.
Rhino. Mm-hmm. Rhino, buffalo,
mm-hmm.
Camel,
mm-hmm.
Lion.
Lion. Yeah, you got this. Okay. All right. Kasumi, what about the third one here?
Tiger, elephant, monkey, giraffe.
Giraffe. Very good, guys. So these are big animals that you'll see at the zoo. And let's get Lena. Can you tell me what these are?
Kangaroo.
Mm-hmm.
Bull.
Okay.
Cow. Mouse.
Mm-hmm. Cow, mouse. Very good. Very good. And then a bull and a cow. Well, you'll see those on a farm, not the zoo. But most of the other ones you'll see. Do you have a question, Stefania?
Yes, I have a question. What is the, how to pronounce bear? And bear, the animal.
Oh yeah. So bird. You're gonna end that with a D sound at the end. Bird.
Bear.
And then bear.
Okay. Bear. Yes.
Yeah. Now you can say yeah. Bird. Bird.
Bird.
Bird.
Okay.
Okay. And then what's this one?
Bear.
Yeah, bear.
Bear.
Okay. Bear.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, we can do some more practice on that too. I'll make a note so we can do some more lessons on bird and bear because they sound very similar.
Yes.
Bird, bear. It's just it's very important to pronounce that last D here. So bird. And then bear just ends with an R noise.
Okay.
So I'll post more on that. Here, well, Stefania, what about this road? Can you read this for me?
Rat.
Mm-hmm.
Eagle.
Mm-hmm.
Snake.
Mm-hmm.
Lizard? I don't know.
Yeah, lizard. Yeah, you got to pronounce this D here. Lizard.
Lizard.
Lizard, yeah.
Okay.
See, this is one of those where it's pronounced lizard. So you would say that A more like an E. So lizard, lizard.
Oh, okay, okay.
Hmm? And so let's see if we get Dat. Can you read the second line for me?
Yeah. Frog, shark, whale, dolphin.
Okay. And so this one we say shark.
Shark.
Shark, yeah. Shark. It's a very scary animal in the ocean. All right. So let me get a Jesus. Can you do this line for me?
Yes, crab, octopus, turtle, crocodile.
Yeah, very good. You've got that, my friend. All right, we'll get Jay. Do this last line for me.
Bee, fly, spider, butterfly.
Butterfly. Yeah, so you guys got that. So that was a very interesting little chapter on animals, but it's good to have pronunciation practice. So let's go back into talking about the future. So making predictions. So when you make prediction, you're using the future with the word will. So we use will to say what you think will happen in the future when you don't have firm evidence for your prediction. So that means you don't completely know, but you're just kind of making an assumption or a prediction. Assumption and prediction are very similar. So here's an example. That movie is great. They will love it. So that's like saying, let's talk about so Stefania talked about Avatar. It's a show on Netflix. So Stefania said, that show is great. You will love it. She knows that she likes it. So she thinks that you will love it too. So she's making a prediction there. So let's look at some more examples of this. We're also going to use the past simple of to be here. So let's each read these out loud. So Giovanna, can you read this example for me?
Jen, will you like the new house? It's really nice.
Yeah, it's really nice. Okay. All right. And let me get Stefania. Can you do this one for me?
We will not get home before midnight.
Okay. We will not get home before midnight. Maybe we're running late. All right. Lena, can you read this example for me?
They will enjoy their holiday in Venice.
Yeah, in Venice. Yeah, very good. Very good. So, you know, normally just one thing, we usually contract that. So we'll say they'll instead of they will. So let me get Kasumi. Can you do this one for me?
It rains every day this summer.
Every day this summer. Okay. All right, Elmer, what about this sentence for me?
Do you want be late for work again this year?
Okay. And then I'll get Dat. Can you read this last sentence for me?
She'll be really angry when she finds out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so pretty much all of these are making predictions because we're not completely sure, but we have a pretty good idea. So more complex things here. So will is called a modal verb. So its form doesn't change with the subject. So she will love the new movie. He will love the new song. Elmer will love the new car. The children will love the new fast food restaurant. Will is always going to be the same there. So let's do an example here. So we're going to fill in the gaps. So you have love in parentheses, and we're going to add will to it. So you will love my new sweater. So let me start with number one. Kasumi, what can you tell me about John here?
Okay. John will not eat pizza.
Yeah, John will not eat pizza. Okay, very good. All right, Jesus, what about number two?
Maria will enjoy the new dance class.
Okay, yeah, so that's easy. Okay, all right. Debbie, number three. Maybe Giovanna, number three.
I don't know. I use you are. Susie and Bella are. Who you are.
Okay. So, yeah, no, we don't have to change this word, and we just add will.
Okay. Susie and Bella, will you be really for working this week?
Yeah, so early.
Early, yeah. Early.
Yeah, good. So we're saying that Susie and Bella will be early for work this week. Maybe they got in trouble last week because they were late. So we're making that prediction, but we're pretty sure that Susie and Bella will be early for work this week. And let me get Lena. Can you do this one for me?
The children will not understand this information.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, so we're just adding will to these verbs. It's very easy to do, and it's how we make predictions. So this says we're going to rewrite the highlighted phrases using pronouns and the contracted will with the future verbs. So essentially what we're going to do here is instead of using these names, we're going to use pronouns instead. So here's the first example. It says Ben will buy pizzas. So essentially you just change this to he'll buy pizzas. Instead of he will, we're going to make a contraction with he'll. But first, why don't we have somebody read this whole paragraph for me? Who wants to read the whole paragraph? All right, Debbie, go ahead.
Hey, Jim, what do you want us to bring to movie nights? Ben will buy pizzas. because he always does. John will bring chocolates and Mary will make a salad. As usual, David won't bring anything. I will bring drinks and Lillian and Joe will buy cheese. Is that okay, Sandy?
Yeah, that's good. So maybe, you know, they're planning a movie night. So we saw the first example. We were talking about Ben. So we know he'll buy pizzas. So let's not worry about this. Let's just look at this section here. So if I wanted to change this to just the pronoun talking about what John's going to do, Stefania, how would I say this?
He'll bring chocolate.
Yeah, that's it. Very good, Stefania. So he'll bring chocolates because we're doing contractions with the will too. So very good, very good. Okay, let me get Dat. Can you do this one for me?
She'll make a salad.
Yeah, she'll make a salad. So it's a good way to really shorten that. Okay. All right. Now this one can be a little tricky. Liazette, can you do this one for me?
Yes, I can. David won't bring anything, right? As usual, yeah. David won't bring anything. Hello.
Mm-hmm. But wait, so let's use a pronoun there.
Won't bring anything? I mean, will not bring anything? I'm sorry, I skipped your question, so I can't understand what you want.
It's okay. So this one is tricky. So, you know, the pronoun would be he. So you could say he won't bring anything, but we're also trying to make a contraction. So if we wanted to do that with a pronoun and the will, we could say he'll bring nothing. So we could change. So David won't bring anything. We could also say he'll bring nothing.
He'll bring nothing. He'll, mm-hmm. Double L. Hell, gotcha. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you.
Because you can't say, we can't say he. Well, you can say he won't bring anything, but when you want to change, we want to use he'll, we have to change that anything to nothing. So he'll bring nothing. We can. I'll post some more examples of that one too. So let me, Kasumi, can you do this next one here?
I bring drinks.
Okay, so let's merge these together. So I would just be I'll. I'll bring drinks, yeah. So yeah, so you could just say I'll bring drinks. So that one's easy. We're just combining I and will to I'll. It'll be I apostrophe LL.
Okay.
Yeah. And let's see. So Giovanna, can you do this last one for me?
I don't know.
No, you got it. That's it. You can say they'll. So they'll buy cheese. Yeah.
Buy cheese.
Mm-hmm. So Lily and Joe becomes they, and then mm-hmm. they will becomes they'll. So they'll buy cheese. So it's just ways that you can make that a little bit shorter and when we're still talking about the future. Honestly, I'm going to post some more examples of that so that makes a little bit more sense to you guys. Let me write it down. So let's go to the next one here. So we get one where we get to listen to the audio. So we're going to listen to the audio, and then we're going to match these questions to the correct answers. So I will play this audio in 3, 2, and 1.
Hi, Jenny. Are you excited about the birthday party?
Not really. There's so much to do.
Well, your friends and family can help. What do you need to do?
First, I need to clean the house.
Oh, well, your sister will do that in the morning.
Well, yes. You're right. She's really tidy. I also need to find some good music.
Marcia will do that. She always takes her CDs to people's parties.
You're right. But I also need to get some party games.
Oh, Sam will do that. She has a huge collection of party games.
Okay. I'll ask her about that. Then I need a birthday cake.
Your mom will bake one. She won't let you have a party without a cake.
Yes, okay. And the last thing, I need someone to do the food.
Your brother will do that. He loves cooking burgers and sausages on the barbecue.
Yeah, okay.
Anything else?
No, I don't think so.
Well, let me know. I can help too.
Thanks, Pete. That's great.
All right, so I think she figured out who's going to do everything for this party. So let me ask, so number one, it says, who will find the party music? Who can answer that for me? Oh, I saw Lizette. I saw your hand go up first.
I think it was Marshall.
It was Marcia. Yeah, Marcia.
Mm-hmm. Marcia, it's the girl. Yeah, she can. Yeah. She can find the music. Yeah,
she can find the music. All right, and Dad, so your hand is up. Dad, who will bring the party games?
Yeah, Sam. Sam will do it.
Yeah, so Sam's going to bring the games. Okay, I see two more hands. I'll get. So we'll get a Jesus. Who will bake a birthday cake?
The mother will do it.
Yeah, so Jenny's mother. And then Lena. Mother. Yeah, Lena, who will cook the food?
Jenny's brother will do it.
Yeah, Jenny's brother. Yeah, so I think you guys are getting really good at this. So that's I think those are good little activities. We get to hear English in a different voice. So let's look at another grammar point. So think with will. So if you're not sure about something, you can begin a sentence with, I think. This shows that you're giving your opinion. So here's an example. We think that he'll like the play. So we think that he'll like the play, but we don't know for sure. Let's look at some more. This is kind of the structure for how we do that with will. So the subject is we think that he'll like the play. Now, sometimes we leave that out, but to make it make more sense, we would need to put that there. So we think that he'll like the play, but you can also say we think he'll like the play. Some English speakers will say that, sometimes they won't. So let's get some more good examples with this. I think this is the best way. So Stefania, can you read this first sentence for me?
I think that we'll have enough food for the party.
So Stefania said, I think we'll have enough food. So she hopes we have enough food, but she thinks that. Okay. Let me get a Devi. What about this one?
It's cold outside, but we don't think it will snow today.
Okay. Yeah, we're not sure. Okay. All right, Elmer, what about this one? Or Grace, could you read this one for me?
I'm sorry, Junior, driving right now.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay.
Sorry.
Let's see. Yeah, Grace, can you hear me?
Yes.
Do this one for me.
He says it will be a great show tonight.
Yeah, so he thinks it'll be a great show tonight. Okay, good, Grace. And we'll get Alina to do this one for me.
Peter doesn't think he will get that job at the bank.
Okay, yeah, maybe she didn't have a good interview, so she doesn't think she'll get the job. So we'll see, you know, using these words is a good way to talk about predictions. And that's what we talked about here. We talked about the future tense, we talked about prediction verbs, and we talked about predicting future events. So let's move on and talk about going to and will. Now, I think you're familiar with going to. So we use going to when you have evidence for a prediction. And we use will when a prediction is opinion without evidence. So let's look at the sentence. I think number 5 will win. So they're probably talking about like race cars or horses here. So I think number 5 will win. Look, number 5 is going to win. So the difference between this is, I think number 5 will win. That's what your thought. You think that's your opinion, but you don't know that. You don't have any evidence. But then this one, look, number 5 is going to win. Maybe number 5 is leading the pack, and you can see, yeah, he's probably going to win. So going to is more definite. Will is more of your opinion. So let's look at, these are some good examples here. So it says, say these sentences out loud, filling in the gaps using the phrases in the panel. So the example here says, Lily is going to jump the fence. So see, Lily is the person riding the horse, and the horse is walking up to the fence. So you know that Lily is going to jump the fence. So let's do number 1. Jay, tell me about Bob here.
Bob is going to finish all his, you know.
Okay, Jay, well, okay, Grace, you go ahead. Jay, we'll let you do the next one. All right, Grace, you said Bob is going to eat all his dinner. So that was Bob. Right. So, oh, go ahead.
Okay. Sorry. Because the world is so small. Bob is going to finish all his dinner.
Okay. So let's pick a word from down here, though. Which one of these words?
Eat.
Eat, yeah. Eat. So Bob is going to eat all his dinner.
Eat all his dinner.
Mm-hmm. And we use going to because Bob looks pretty hungry and he's about to eat that. So that's not our opinion. We know that Bob is going to eat his dinner. So Jay, do number 2 for me here.
It is going to snow this afternoon.
Yeah, it's going to snow this afternoon. This person knows it's going to snow because they can look up and see it in the sky, okay? And so now these are more, this one's more of an opinion. So Stefania, can you read number 3 for me?
Yes, the dog will eat these leftovers.
Yeah, leftovers.
Yes, what is that?
Okay.
Left, now what? Lovers.
Okay. Now, Stefania, why is that an opinion?
I don't know.
That's okay. So it looks like, so she's packing up some leftovers, and she says the dog will eat these leftovers, but she doesn't know that. Maybe the dog won't eat the leftovers. She's just making a prediction.
Okay.
So that's why when we look at these pictures, when we say the dog will eat the leftovers, we don't know that. But if we say Lily is going to jump the fence, well, we see the horse is about to jump the fence. So we know that's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
But we don't know this will happen.
Okay.
So let me get Kasumi. Can you do number 4 for me?
The car is going to turn left.
Okay. Now, Kasumi, do we know the car is going to turn left, or is that an opinion?
No opinion.
Yeah, well, you can barely see it, but there's a turn signal here.
Yes.
So we know the car is going to turn left because we can see this turn signal.
Okay.
Okay. I know that these pictures are kind of small. I wish they weren't so small. So let's do this last one. Let me get Giovanna. Can you read the last one for me?
John thinks he will go out tonight.
Yeah, so he thinks he will go out tonight. Now, is that an opinion or is that something he knows?
This opinion.
Yeah, it's an opinion because maybe he's not sure if this girl's going to say yes. I don't know. Maybe he doesn't know. Maybe he's about that confidence. So, you know, I'm going to post some more examples of this in our WhatsApp. So just so you'll really understand these concepts too. So let's quickly get into this last little bit today. It says making quick decisions. Now, we're still using the future with will here. So if you suddenly decide to do something while you're speaking, we use will to say what you're going to do. So if I go outside and I say, oh, it's raining, I'll take my umbrella. So that when you use will, it shows that you've just made that decision. Because remember, this is the contraction. This is I will. I will take my umbrella. So that's how you show that you're doing something right in that moment. So let's look at more examples. Stefania, can you read this example for me?
It's midnight, so I won't walk home through the park.
Through the park, yeah. So maybe he just said, you know, it's midnight, so I'm not going to walk home because maybe it's dangerous. So what about this one, Lena? Lena, can you do this one for me? Maybe Kasumi can do this one for me.
Okay. This apple is delicious. I have another one.
Okay, yeah. So maybe Kasumi ate one apple and she said, wow, that was delicious. I'll have another one. So let's look at another grammar point here. So we're going to use so, and in that case, so we use so or the expression in that case to link a situation and the decision you make as a result of that situation. So the examples are more clear, I think. So there's no juice, so I'll have water. The car won't start. In that case, we'll walk. So you use these expressions when you have to link something to that situation. So I could say there's no milk, so I'll have water. Or I could say there's no chips, so I'll have pretzels. Or there's no meat, so I'll have a salad. I could say my bicycle is broken. In that case, I'll walk. My car's tire fell off. In that case, I'll ride my bike. It's just a way to link this together. So here is a good example here. We're going to match these sentences to the correct endings here. So let me get Giovanna, can you read this example?
There no bread. So I'll go to the supermarket.
Yeah, okay. So there's no bread. That's the situation. And we're going to use so and say, so I'll go to the supermarket. Maybe to buy more bread. So let me get Devi. Can you do this first one, number one here?
Yes, it's my birthday.
Okay.
So I'll cut the cake.
So I'll cut the cake. Yes, yeah, it's his birthday cake. Okay. All right. Let me get Jay. Do number two for me.
I forgot my swimming trunks. So I won't go in the water.
Yeah, so I won't go in the water, okay? All right, Liza.
I just want to say, I'm driving. I can't.
Oh, it's okay. You can drive, Liza. Okay, let me get Dap. Can you do this one for me?
I don't have any money, so I won't go shopping.
So I won't go shopping, okay. All right, let me get Lena. Can you do number four for me?
My friend. So I will get the bus.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, so I can't find my train ticket, so I'll get the bus. Now, that should say I'll take the bus. So I apologize. There's a typo there. But but you were right, Lena, is this one. So I'll take the bus. So let's listen to the audio, and we're going to number the pictures here. So there's five things to click. Let's see how this one works.
So, Jen, are we going to the theater tonight?
We can't. There aren't any shows on.
Oh, in that case, let's go to the movies instead. I want to see that new spy thriller.
That's a good idea.
So I'm not sure how this is supposed to work. It says listen to the audio and number the pictures. And I think they just kind of told us. So A would be number one. Here, let's just click. I want you to be able to listen to these. So let's just listen to these, and then I'll ask you a question about what they said. So let's listen to this one more time.
So, Jen, are we going to the theater tonight?
We can't. There aren't any shows on.
Oh, in that case, let's go to the movies instead. I want to see that new spy thriller.
That's a good idea.
All right, so Stefania, what are they going to watch tonight?
Sorry, I can't hear.
It's okay. Here, you want to play one more time?
Yes, please.
Okay, one more time.
So, Jen, are we going to the theater tonight?
We can't. There aren't any shows on.
Oh, in that case, let's go to the movies instead. I want to see that new spy thriller.
That's a good idea.
They want to the theater?
Yeah, what did he say they were going to see?
The spy umbrella?
Yeah, the spy thriller is what he said.
Yes.
It's okay. Yeah, so a thriller is like a very exciting movie. So very good.
Oh, okay.
You're going to see the spy thriller. So let's listen to this one and see what happens.
Hi, Sam. It's Martin.
Oh, hi, Martin. Are you still coming tonight?
Yes, but it's really windy right now, so I won't cycle into town.
Oh, okay. Do you want me to pick you up in the car?
No, I'll walk. It's not very far.
Okay, great. See you later.
Okay, so I think that was describing this picture. So, Dad, what was the weather condition he was talking about?
Is it raining?
Yeah, and he said it's really windy too, right?
Yeah, windy.
Okay.
Yeah. So she walk.
Yeah, that's right. It just, you know, as we listen to these, I just want you to tell me something about it. So you got that right, okay?
Okay.
So let's do the next one here.
I'm hungry, Andre. What are we going to have for dinner?
Burger and fries, I think. Oh, but there's no burgers.
Sorry, I ate them for lunch.
Well, there's pizza. That's all we've got.
Sounds great. We'll have that then.
All right, and Kasumi, what did these two people decide to eat?
He want to eat burger and fry, but no, they eat pizza.
Yeah, they had pizza. That's all they had left. Okay. All right, good. So let's listen to the next audio. So get ready for it.
So, Jen, are we going to the theater tonight?
We can't. There aren't any shows on.
Oh, in that case, Let's go to the movies instead. I want to see that new spy thriller.
That's a good idea.
Okay, so I think Stefania already answered this one, but Stefania, tell me one more time. What are they going to see?
They going to the theater.
Mm-hmm. And what were they going to see?
I don't know.
I think, you know, it's the spy thriller.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one. But, okay.
What is the movie? I don't know.
Yeah, it's just like a spy. It's just like a spy thriller. Is just a type of movie. So like, if you saw James Bond or Mission Impossible, that's what a spy thriller is.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. That was a little confusing, guys. I'm sorry.
Yes.
So here is this one makes a little bit more sense here. So it says, fill in the gaps. It says, wow, it's really sunny outside. In that case, I'll wear a hat. Okay, so we're just filling in these blanks with these words down here. So, Jay, can you do number one for me?
Oh, dear, there is no rain today. In that case, we will go by bus.
Yeah, we'll go by bus. Okay, very good, very good. All right, Lena, what about number two?
There isn't any coffee in the kitchen. In that case,
Yeah, so this one would be, I'll have tea. So yeah, so I'll have tea instead of coffee there. Some people use, like, instead of saying I'll drink tea, they'll just say I'll have tea, like when it's a choice. So let's see, I think Liazette is still driving. What about Kasumi? Can you do number three?
Oh no, the restaurant is closed. In that case, we'll eat at home.
Eat at home. Okay, very good. And then Jesus, number four here.
There is nothing good on the TV tonight. In that case, I'll listen to music.
Yeah, I'll listen to music. Okay, very good, guys. So here is more grammar points. You can use think with will to show that your decision is something that you are considering. When we say considering, we mean something you are thinking about. So I am tired. I think I'll go to bed. That means you're deciding now, but you're not completely sure. So you'll hear these a lot in English too. So we are running over time, guys. So if you do need to leave, that's fine. But we were almost done here. So let me get Dat. Can you read this one for me?
Yeah, there are lots of opinions on the menu. I think we'll have the fish.
Okay, so this is, there's a lot of options on the menu. Options, that mean a lot of selections.
Yeah.
Okay, let me get Grace. Can you read the second one for me?
There are lots of hands to see. But I think I will watch the rock band.
The rock band. Okay, yeah.
Rock band.
Yeah, rock band. Maybe they went to a concert tonight. There's a lot of bands. But Grace is going to see the rock band. So very good.
Okay.
And let me see. Debbie, can you read this one for me?
This movie is terrible. I think I leave before the end.
Okay, I'll leave before the end. Okay. Sometimes you're just not that good and you just want to leave, right? And let me get Giovanna. Let's do this one here.
It's getting really hot outside. I think I'll put my shorts on.
Yeah, I think I'll put my shorts on just so it's a little cooler. So this one, this is a good activity. It says we're going to read the text messages. So let's start with these. So let's each read one of these things here. So we'll start from the top. Or hey Zeus, read this one for me.
Okay. Is Jenny's birthday this week? Is Jenny's birthday this weekend? Do you know what we can do for her? Sorry.
Okay. And Lena, do this one.
Sure, Joe. I think I could get her some flower and DVD.
All right, very good. And we'll get maybe Liazette. Can you read this one for me?
I'm sorry, I can't read. I'm driving.
Still. Oh, you're still driving. Okay, sorry. Sorry.
I'm sorry.
Okay, Stefania, can you read this one?
I'm listening to your conversation. I'm just listening to your conversation and lessons. I'm sorry.
It's okay, Stefania. We'll get you to do this one.
Great. I think you take her shopping and buy her some clothes. What will James do?
All right. Kasumi, read this one.
James will have a party for her at his house on Tuesday.
Okay. All right. Giovanna, read this one for me.
Perfect. John will cook the food and bake her a cake.
A cake? Yep, you got that. Okay, and Dad, read this last one.
Oh, and I think Jamimia will buy Jenny some movie tickets and take her shopping.
Okay, so we read the text message. So it's her birthday this weekend. Get her some flowers and a DVD, take her shopping. We saw what happened. So let's answer these questions just true, false. And when I read this, anybody can answer. So number one, it says one friend will take her to a restaurant. Is that true or false? All right, go ahead, Lena. You said false?
Yeah,
you're right. I don't think it said anything about a restaurant. Yeah, so that was false. Okay. All right. Number two, it says one friend will have a party for her. Is that true or false? Go ahead, Debbie.
Yeah, true. James will have party for her. That's
yeah, okay. Very good. Okay. Number three, I see Stefania, your hand is up.
False.
False. Yeah, I didn't see anything. What are these things called, Stefania?
Ballet tickets.
Yeah, ballet tickets. Okay. And you're right. So that one was false. Okay. Yeah. What about number four? It says two friends will take her shopping. Is that true or false?
It's true.
It's true, yeah, because so here's one that says, I'm going to take her shopping. And then also it says Jemima is going to take her shopping too. So number five, it says one friend will make her a birthday cake. Is that true or false? Go ahead, Debbie.
It's true.
True, because John.
John didn't do that.
Okay. And Lena, I see your hand is up, so you can do the last one. One friend will buy her a DVD.
True.
It's true. Yeah, true. Up here it says, I'll get her flowers and a DVD. So you guys do good linking these together with these concepts that we're talking about. So let me see. How many more? So let's do one more activity, and then I promise we'll be done. I know we're running over, but I really want people to get this practice. So here's, it says, the TV is broken. What will you do tonight? I think I'll read a book. And so we're just filling in those blanks from the bottom. So for this last activity, let me see if I can get Kasumi. Do number one for me.
There's no juice. What do you want to drink? I think I have milk.
Yeah, have milk. Okay, very good, very good. All right, Stefania, do this one for me.
What time are you leaving work? I think I'll leave at
6:30 p.m.
Perfect. Good pronunciation there. 6:30 p.m. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Let me get Grace. Can you do this one for me?
Joe is busy, so who are you playing tennis with? I think I will play with Cassie.
Cassie, yeah, you got that. I think I'll play with Cassie, okay? Very good. All right, hey, Zeus, do this one for me.
Which TV show do you want to see? I think I'll watch the news.
Watch the news, very good, okay. And I'll get Giovanna, do this last one for me.
Where do you want to go now? I think I'll go home.
Yeah, just go home, okay. Yeah, so I think you guys are doing really good with those. So we continued to talk about these quick decisions with Will. We talked about these decision words, and we talked about some future actions. So I know we ran a little late today, everyone, but does anybody have any questions about what we talked about today?
No, everything's good.
Well, I think we're good, guys. You know, I'll continue to share things about this in the WhatsApp just for extra help. But as always, if you don't mind, team, if you could show your camera for just a little bit so I can take a picture of all of our lovely faces in class today. And so I will take this picture in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. If you could wave at me or give me a peace sign, or I see balloons over Stefania's screens. Well, I want to thank everybody for coming again. It means a lot to me that you come to this class, and I hope you are enjoying it. And if you ever have any questions or need any extra help, you can always reach out to me. So thank you guys for coming, and you have a good rest of your day.
Thank you for your lesson. Bye. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.